John Mitchum, American. You asked me why I loved him? Give me time and I'll explain. Did you ever hear him tell a funny story? Or watch him drive a stuffed shirt person plumb insane? Have you drifted with his memories of exotic things so far away? Or watch him do some shocking thing just to see what folks would say? Have you heard about his adventures on the Allegheny and the old Rock Island line? Or heard the bellow of his temper when someone drank up all the wine? We all thrilled to his ability to make the people roar, and we stood in awe and wonder, and we always wanted more. 'Cause he was there for everyone. He was sound as Plymouth Rock, and his timing was impeccable, like a fine grandfather clock. He'd tell you about the snowflakes drifting in the Rockies way up high, and his eyes would get a soft and misty look. Then they'd blink and glisten back at you like a bright Nevada sky. He finally found a home near Columbia in the county of Tuolumne, and there he bowed his head and finally realized that this was the place he was always meant to be. For he had seen the mighty Tetons, and he helped the eagles soar, and he realized and was glad that the mighty Mississippi would always roll along Missouri's shore, and that his old bones never had to feel the chill in Michigan, and he never again had to curse those winter ways. And he'd call me every once in a while, and we talked of poems and songs or plays. John, my friend, it is aloha, and its sound does make me warm, for it's not hello or goodbye, but it is rest from the unforgiving storm. I will think of you often, but not in pain and stress or in grief. The memory of your laughter and friendship will wash over me like the surf that comes pounding in off a Waimea reef. From Alaska's cold to the Everglades, from the Rio Grande to Maine, my heart cries out, my pulse beats fast, and the memories will remain. You ask me why I loved him? I've a million reasons why. John Mitchum, American. God bless you, my gentle friend. Goodbye.